everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch. It's the Buccaneers going up against the Cardinals. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are about 15 miles west of downtown Phoenix at University of Phoenix Stadium here in Glendale. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Arizona Cardinals. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you look at this Cardinal team as they get ready here. The losers their last time out, so they'll look to make amends here.
And one of the best ways you can do that is to be at home, and they are. They're going to try and ride that home crowd and that wave of emotion to a victory in this one.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Bucs, they were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week, they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Holding, receiving team.
Really? Come on. That starts off with a bang.
They come up with one running back. That's Bell. Osweiler. This one grabbed by AJ Green.
First down.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And they thought they could exploit this defense with some really quick hitters, quick action. They worked on that in practice. We just saw it there.
And we saw them break it down to the fundamentals as well. Each position group had their own little work on it. You know, they worked on a drill here with the receivers, a drill there with the quarterbacks. Then they brought it all together, and now it's paying off in the game.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Here's Osweiler. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Yeah.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
I think I'm starting to get my hands.
Speed, I mean, can flat-out run. You put that whole package together.
Le'Veon Bell!
Oh!
It's a foot race.
Oh!
Touchdown, Tampa Bay!
Wide open!
His second touchdown on the season. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. So a big-time scamper there to cap a touchdown on the opening drive.
Sets a tone, establishes not what you'd call a dominance, but a really good feeling for the team that just scored. But I've got to ask you, partner, what do the analytics say about that type of a run? Does it establish anything else for them?
And that one gives the Bucs a 7-0 lead.
Yes!
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. That's fielded in the end zone. And this will be a touchback. And as we saw in week one, the new rule, this one coming out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Cardinals now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by their rookie quarterback out of North Dakota State. It's Carson Wentz.
And if you didn't know what school Carson Wentz came from, if you didn't know he had played at a 1AA or FCS level, and you looked at his measurables, you would say, now that's what a quarterback's supposed to look like. 6'5", nearly 240 pounds, with the ability to run the football as well. He has the goods.
All right.
A gain of 3, second down.
And the quarterback
has got some big threats at wideout.
And they seem to get bigger all the time, don't they, Brandon? Every time I look out and watch a game, we're getting these bigger, more athletic, acrobatic receivers. We have some today.
Yeah, on my team. My team's wide receivers are huge. All right, guys, let's do this.
Here we go. Green, 39.
On the ground, Rodgers. And he's going to lose yardage here. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
And that play was vintage Derek Johnson. Made a play in the backfield. In college, he did as an outside linebacker. Used speed to get to the backfield. Now, a bulked up inside linebacker with multiple fumbles on his resume.
Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down. On fourth down, here's Pat McAfee to kick it away.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Very good return that time. 18 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. So here are the Bucs now to take over for the first time. They'll be led out by the second tallest quarterback in league history at 6'7". It's Brock Osweiler.
I saw Brock Osweiler throw in a practice session while he was in college, and it's never left me the memory of how smooth he was throwing the ball, how accurate he was, and what a catchable ball he threw.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit.
What?
Ball pops out. Incomplete. And how about this wide receiving core, Charles?
Well, I was in the hotel watching a little film, and you popped your head in and said, these receivers are pretty good from what I can tell. You're exactly right. Can't wait to see them do their thing out on the field.
Here we go now. Boom.
Off the play fake. Here's Osweiler. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman, and his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line.
Bad. That should
Arizona
not have made
getting
that call.
Ready to go as they take the field.
Oh, well.
And
whatever.
The last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Let's go! Green 39! Green 39!
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. Well, they try to swing it on left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackle.
Negative 1 yards
like
attempted.
A great boxer. They
That's
were on their
crazy.
Toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Call it a gain of 10, and they pick up the first.
Forget height and catch radius. When you run the fade really well, run down the defender, kind of take him a little bit towards the middle of the field, and then fade to the sideline and give your quarterback some space. It can be executed that well, just as we saw.
It's brought in right side by Ginn.
Oh, come on. Couldn't hit him.
The 30. It'll go as a gain of 12, and that'll be good for an Arizona first down.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to grade the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. See if they stay on the ground for second down.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball,
great.
He's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
This is going great. I mean, aside from my long touchdown run, which I don't want to quit because of that.
Is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out.
Come on.
Green 39!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing.
Short.
He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the
damn it!
And other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football.
Blocking, guys. Come on.
But you do say, guess what? We can throw well with a whole lot of confidence.
There's another example of why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse.
In trouble, and they go down back at the 12. Adrian Claiborne in there to sack him for a loss of 6.
Well, in my time in football, I've yet to see a playbook that draws up offensive plays designed to lose yardage. A running play loses yardage on first down. They try and throw it, take a sack on second down. What can the offensive coordinator come up with here on third down?
He hits Rodgers in
the
flat.
That was a terrible play.
Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up fourth down. Now on fourth down, Bruce Arians will send out his field goal unit from the right hash, and this one just a chippy.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd run to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to
first
take
down.
It, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball to the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Yeah, man, mostly pass anyway.
They send Green to the left on his own. Now Osweiler, right side, caught by Jackson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 2 minutes remain here in the first half.
All right, let's score down a touchdown. Let's
more
do it,
from
guys.
The desert after this. A reminder that coming up at halftime, we'll join Larry Ridley in Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. So we look forward to that.
And I'm looking forward to some air conditioning.
I bet you are. They come up with one running back. That's Bell. Throwing. Osweiler. Green's got it over the middle. 12 yards on the pickup. And that'll be good enough for a Tampa Bay first down. Simple slant route, and part of a really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
Osweiler, it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do.
Green.
It reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Here's Osweiler to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a 1st and goal.
And they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position. But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean that's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many pro style where you actually have a true fullback. We're having to make do in the
NFL. Oh, come on!
And put guys in that spot who emulate it but aren't necessarily that position.
Seriously? Ridiculous. Ridiculous.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Again, Osweiler. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
Osweiler, and he comes back with one complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play.
I'm going to pass it to Gronkowski.
All right, here we go. Blue line.
On third and goal, Osweiler. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It'll be a pickup of just 2. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal. And Boswell's kick is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is going to lose yardage here.
Yeah.
So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we send you on down to our studios in Orlando, where standing by is Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Cardinals haven't played their best football and trail because of it. The Buccaneers have come in and looked good as the road team and will just keep trying to play hard and maintain the lead going forward. All right, let's get it going. Let's roll those first half highlights. Now first and 10, Bell's got a running lane here and nobody can stop him on this long touchdown. The Buccaneers is up now by 7. Now second and 8, slant route connection made here. And the pass and catch will end up going for 16 yards. However, they only come away with a field goal on the drive. So that'll do it from our EA Sports Studios. Now let's get you back out to Glendale as we check back in with Brandon Gott.
Still up by a touchdown, that's what matters.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the defensive unit now for the Buccaneers onto the field. They had a pretty solid first half. Not many adjustments, but I guess there's probably always some adjustments that can be made.
Usually it's just tightened down on the things we've worked on all week in practice. Everyone thinks adjustments are bringing in something absolutely new. For the most part, it's tweaks or just emphasizing what you've worked on already. And that's what they're planning to do here.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Oh, I almost got it back.
On plays like this, where the ball comes through, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball. Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Call it a gain of 5. And that's going to make it 4th down. Here's Pat McAfee now as he'll punt it away for the second time.
All right, I'm up by a touchdown. Let's score again.
Very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath. By all means.
Fielded just inside the 20. So a change of possession here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room. Here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
We got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut him down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 7 yards on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
A pretty good coverage there. These defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. Osweiler, and he's got his man in stride, complete. And he eventually goes down.
That was an amazing play.
Reaching the 30-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run. And on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. Now Bell hit. He lost the football.
Got it back.
So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right. Lost opportunity.
The corner from Compton, Mr. Sherman getting the hand in there to knock that one away.
And what a path of his to where he is right now. From Compton to Stanford, was a wide receiver at Stanford before flipping around, becoming a defensive back. Lightly drafted. Remember, he went late in the draft for them and has turned into one of the best ones out there. I think his ability to be close on the play, and it has such great timing right at the end to get in there and knock balls away.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on 3rd down. So now at 3rd and 12 with an extra defender here in the secondary, a nickel look. They got a man over the middle. It's Woods. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be 4th down. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning.
I'll take a field goal. I'm up 10 points. Fine by me.
I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. So put another 3 on the board, and all things considered, a good opening drive here to begin the 3rd quarter.
It sure was. I think as a head coach, you're happy to come out and put a little drive together, take the 3 points, and build on your lead.
So out now come the Cardinals. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Here we go.
Just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Throwing is Wentz. Complete over the middle to Hardy. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it's a second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running
He tripped on his own guy. Yeah.
Zone. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Wasn't that long ago that the NFL guys really didn't adopt much from the college game. But one thing that has crept in there is spreading things out, opening things up, not even just in tempo, but maybe getting better
at
running splits and spreading the field. I think that would be a great strategy right now to try and open things up in the run game.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Not even that. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's Cardinal football, but they trail here as we get set to bring you the fourth and final quarter.
All right, guys, let's bring it home. Down by two touchdowns right now. Basically.
Wentz now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Here's Wentz to throw. And that one got tipped. Nope. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
While we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore, I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football. And you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
He finds Aguilar short in the middle. It'll be a gain of four. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands.
Green 39! Green 39!
Now Wentz, got to have this one.
Incomplete!
Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now really hoping for a turnover.
There are a good number of coaches that any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through.
He dropped it again? Come on!
Play. It was
stop dropping passes.
Looked like he had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. They send Green to the left on his own. On third down, Osweiler. He's got his man here. It's Green. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
On second down, Osweiler. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Now it's Osweiler. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. So he makes the grab, and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
They come up with one running back. That's Bell. Now Osweiler, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose.
Jeez,
and brings up
my
second
receivers
down.
Are not holding on to the ball at all. Getting ridiculous.
Unable to connect on the first
try
down.
A corner
play.
Route. See.
Now it's second down.
To Gronkowski for a touchdown.
To throw again is Osweiler. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. And numbers to like, that's for sure here. Back-to-back good games. Maybe they found something last week that they can carry forward here, a little blueprint.
Yeah, we often talk about a defense seeing something that held a person down and implementing that themselves. In this case, I think exactly what you said. This is working. Until someone comes up with an answer for it, no reason to go away from it. Plus, let's just face it, he's as good as any receiver in the league. He is just playing at a really high level. They got to continue to find ways to get him the ball.
And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one. And this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to
minute warning.
As well. They've
got to
stop
again.
Him here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Well, they held him out on second down, and now here's third and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone.
1 yard.
Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Brock Osweiler, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead.
Partner, that was simply an example of getting low, wasn't it?
It was indeed. And for the quarterback, so they get low the line. They did their job. Is the quarterback's job just to find a crease? And
find a crease and just get in there. And ordinarily, you start low yourself, get low behind that offensive line. But sometimes they do such a great job, you can almost fall forward and find the crease for a touchdown.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run. 5 yard line.
Let's go! Green 39!
On first and 10, here's Wentz. And complete on the right side to Bennett. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll make it second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They fake the give. Now Wentz. He's got time. He's going to let it fly. That's caught inside the 20. And he gets this down deep into Tampa Bay territory. Throwing on first is Wentz. This will be caught just inside the 10. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Wentz again. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Adrian Claiborne in there to drop him with his first sack of 2016. Now Wentz on third down. Under pressure, and they got to him again. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Let's go!
Laundry on the field. This is going to be a false start on the offense.
Sometimes you have to slow things down a little bit when things get heated. The cadence has to be slow and deliberate at times to make sure your team's ready to go.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
All right, here we go.
Now Wentz, gotta have this one. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Oh, ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover
there.
Yes, interception. These guys will get the football back.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's gonna hurt, and in a big way.
This is Bell, and there's a flag on the field. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24.
Holding offense.
Stop holding offense. Come on.
Still first down.
I mean, it's not like it matters. I'm pretty much
they
got
come
this.
Out with one back and three tight ends. Osweiler. Green's got it over the middle. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll make this a second and long. Second down now after the pass completion. Osweiler's going to throw it, and he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
Nah, I'm good.
All right, Charles,
I'm gonna
win. Win the game. Not only do you get the W in the left-hand column, you get some momentum for the coming week.
Now when you go into the week and you're telling the guys what mistakes have to be corrected, what we have to do to win going forward, you have their full attention. They're excited, they're happy, and they know if they can build that momentum, they can ultimately achieve all their goals.
So for Tampa Bay, it's a dream start. 2 wins in 2 early road games. And they'll return home next week to take on the L.A. Rams. Meanwhile, for Arizona, they'll drop to 0-2. And they'll try to get back on track next week as they head up to Orchard Park to take on the Buffalo Bills.
If Bell's long will run, that's
so that'll just about
game.
Do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. So long, everybody.
Yeah. All right, well, that's going to do it for this stream. I just wanted to finish that game. It was pretty bad. I mean, I don't know why. I'm 2-0. Osweiler has 0 touchdowns. He has 1 rushing touchdown, but he has 0 passing touchdowns. Is that mostly field goals? I don't know. I don't think my team's amazing, but they're not bad, so I think I'll just get better using them. So there you go. That's my game. And that's